Friends, we are discussing about a magnetic moment and Bohr magneton. A magnetic moment M is created and or generated when the current flows through a closed loop. Then we can say M equals to IA, where A is the area and I is the current and M is the magnetic moment, and then Bohr magneton. The magnitude of spin moment is contributed by an electron. Then we can say it is Bohr magneton. MB, mu B means Bohr magneton equals to EH by 2M. See here, this is the radius. Here the electron which is passing through a closed loop with a velocity V. Then we can say how much current is produced by an electron. For that equation, I equals to E by T. For completing the one revolution, the time is taken for the electron. So we can say that T equals to 2 pi by omega. It is considered as the third equation. We know that the frequency of electron is V equals to 1 by T. V is the frequency and 1 by T is the time. So from the equation T, we can write it as omega by 2 pi. So frequency equals to omega by 2 pi. When we substitute fourth equation in term 2, then we can write I equals to E by T is I equals to E omega by 2 pi. The magnetic moment of the electron is M equals to I into A, means this is the magnetic moment, this is the current, A equals to area. When the current flows through a wire and area of the cross section, then we can say it is a magnetic moment. So from that, M equals to IA, we know that I equals to E omega by 2 pi from the equation 4. M equals to E omega by 2 pi into A. We know that A equals to pi r square. M equals to E omega pi r square by 2 pi. When we substitute these values in the equation, we can write M equals to E omega r square by 2. It is also sixth condition. This is, we know that the relation between linear velocity and angular velocity, velocity V equals to R into omega, where the mechanical angular momentum L is given by L equals to MVR. We know that V equals to R into omega. We have to substitute these values in this equation. We get M equals to L equals to M omega R square. It is considered as seventh equation. As per the Bohr's theory, the angular moment of the electron is integral multiple of h by 2 pi. Then L equals to nh by 2 pi. This is the integral multiple of an electron. So comparing 7th and 8th equations, having L equals to m over r square, L equals to nh by 2 pi, we are comparing these two equations, we get r square omega equals to nh by 2 pi. Now substitute 9th equation in 6, we get M equals to 1 by 2 E and H by 2 by M. Then it can be written as N of E H by 4 pi omega. It is a 10th equation. From this equation shows the magnetic moment of an electron is in an integral multiple E H by 4 pi M. E H by 4 pi M was the Bohr magnetic equation. Then since H equals to H by 2 pi, MB equals to EH by 4 pi M, then we get the